Next, a young woman from Plymouth is calling for greater support for recovering alcoholics. Sarah Whitcher started drinking again despite going through rehab because she says she didn't get adequate support when back in the community.
Well, now she's enlisted the help of Fixers, the campaign that gives young people a voice to get her message across.
I was born in Plymouth and spent most of my life here. My name is Sarah Whitcher and I'm 26 years old. Alcohol to me is an addiction. There's always going to be a craving there. For me, drinking leads to crime. It turns me into a nasty person. I get very aggressive and horrible towards people. But when I'm not drinking, I'm down to earth and I'm kind. The problem with alcohol is it's cheap and it was easy to get hold of. My Fixers project is to raise awareness that recovering addicts need ongoing support and educate young people of the dangers of alcohol. I've made a film with Fixers about my experiences. I'd just go out and I couldn't say no, I'd have 10 pints, maybe more. I'd just get plastered. Sometimes I'd end up arrested and I'd end up on charges of assault, but not recalling what I'd done the night before. It was 2 years ago that I decided to sort myself out. When I left rehab, I got back to Plymouth, but there was no support in Plymouth for me. I wanted to stay sober, but unfortunately it didn't happen. I was put in a B&B next to a pub and an off licence. The problem with rehab is once you're out, you're on your own. There's still an everyday struggle, and all you have to help you is willpower. You think to yourself, one drink won't hurt, but it will, because one drink leads to another. There needs to be a lot more support for people that get out of rehab. I have to work hard every day to keep myself sober, because if I don't, I'll know where it's going to lead me.
The fact is, we have a very big and increasing alcohol problem in Plymouth, and we don't have the funding to produce all the resources that we'd like to. So if we can help Sarah talk to people who are funding services, that will only be to the good.
I had a few stints in Eastwood Park Prison through my offending because of my drinking use. I held a presentation in Plymouth to a wide range of people, drug and alcohol agencies, mental health, the council and the police.
I think you've spoken brilliantly. Plymouth says that it's got a tension between the damage caused by alcohol, which they estimated around 20 million, and the value to Plymouth of the night economy and the clubs and bars of around 20 million. How do we resolve this?
If you put the clubs back to what it used to be, no 24-hour openings, you can get eight cans of beer for £6. That's not right. Since I've relapsed, I've had help from two places in Plymouth.
That's it, flatten that. That's it, sir. Well done.
I feel like you shouldn't have to go off the rails to get the help that you need. I'm on a construction course and it helps me keep my mind occupied and I'm out of trouble and I'm not drinking. I look back at my past and I do regret what I've done. I feel bad generally towards the police because they were the main people that I targeted, and I wish, obviously, that I hadn't. I hope the film will make people sit up and listen, that there is a problem with alcohol in Plymouth, a severe problem, and that they do need to sort it out before it's too late.
Oh, well done, Sarah. And I tell you what, so brave as well, not just making the film, but standing up at that conference and talking to those people.
Amazing.
Brilliant. She seems like she's really pulling her life together, which is good news. To see more about that story and more about Fixers in general, visit their website, fixers.org.uk.
Now, the ITV News continues with the national and international stories at 6:30. Our main story is also the main national story tonight. Here's Alistair Stewart with the details.